Hello children, myself Simmi Punchi welcomes you all in this moral science class. How are you all? I am sure you people are taking very good care of yourself, washing your hands, using the sanitizers, and do not go out until it is very urgent. And children, you will have to use mask very carefully. Don't exchange your mask with other children. Eat healthy food. We teachers are really missing you. Now, get ready with moral science book. Take out your moral science book. I will teach you moral science and lesson number one. Take out your moral science book and be ready with pencil also. Page number 4, first chapter, God is love. Once a king called upon all his counselors and ministers together. Do you know why? Children, what do you mean by the word counselors? Counselors means a person whose job is to give advice. So king called all his counselors and ministers together. They had to give a name to God. They wanted to give a name to God. What is the name of God? All started thinking. One of the ministers bowed down and told the king. Bowed down means when you bow to someone, you bend your body and you give respect to someone who is more powerful. And told the king, O Lord, my king, I think that God is the source of all knowledge. Means God is very knowledgeful. So shall we call him eternal wisdom? What do you mean by eternal wisdom? Eternal wisdom means God is always true. He knows what is good, what is bad. He knows what will happen tomorrow. And he knows our thoughts, our plans. That is why they were saying the name of God should be eternal wisdom. Someone else said, God is eternal goodness. Means God is good with everyone. Now, no, he must be called the Almighty. One minister said that we should give the name that God is Almighty. Almighty means having the power to do anything. Very great, all powerful means God is very powerful. So we should say that God is Almighty. Argued another, God is present everywhere. One minister was saying that God is present everywhere. So he is omnipresent, means having the total authority, having the ability to do anything. God can do anything. He is present everywhere. So we should call him omnipresent. Understand, children? Though all the suggested name reflects God nature, the king was not happy. Means the king was not satisfied. They were saying that we should call him eternal wisdom, eternal goodness, we should call him omnipresent. So that king was not satisfied. Then the oldest minister in that group stood up and said, how will it be if we call God love? He said that we should give the name God love. They all liked the name. They all liked the name, clapping their hands together. They clapped their hands together. They said, yes, love is the God of love is the name of God. The king gave so many gifts to that minister. Means king liked that name very much, that we should call God love. God is the love. The flowers and the trees, the birds and the butterflies, the rivers and the oceans, the gardens and the woods are all gift of God. Children, you know that God made the world, God made the flower, God made the rivers, God made the oceans, God made the garden, God made the sky. All things are made by God. God made all the things around us. So God is indeed very great. God created us in His own image and likeness. He has given us many talents and abilities, like the ability to study, the ability to play, ability to sing, ability to dance, ability to paint, ability to walk, ability to smile, and ability to love. These all the talents we have got from the God. All these are the gifts of God to us. He gave us good parents. He gave us good parents, brothers and sisters. God has given us parents. That is why I am telling you that, children, we should always obey our parents and our teachers. Whatever they tell, that is good for us. If we know that they are telling that this is not good for you, this is bad, so we should not do that thing. Our parents do so much for us. You should respect your parents. We should do only those things which please them. Have a quality time. These days you are having very quality time with your parents. Yes or no? Yes. Parents are the visible sign of invisible God. Always remember what? Parents are the visible sign of invisible God. So you always obey your parents and you always obey your teachers. And parents, who has given us our parents? God has given our parents. God has given our brothers. God has given our sister. He also gave us good teachers. Children, teachers are really doing very hard work for you. So always respect your teachers, obey your teachers, and they are teaching good teachers to teach and good friends to play. God has given us good friends. All of you are having your friends now. These days you are doing video calls with your friends also now. That what they are doing, what is their routine. Sometimes you are learning very good things from your friends. So friends are also, God has given you good friends. You like your friends, you play with your friends, you read with your friends, you share things with your friends, and your friends make you laugh when you are sad. So they help us when you are in need. They help you. So friends are also very good gift that God has given to you. Now, next line is that He also gave us good teachers to teach and good friends to play and enjoy. They are all the symbols of God's love. They are all symbols of God's love. Is it enough that we experience God's love? Let's love God in return for His love. What should we do? That we should also love God. How can we say that we love God? Joining our hands, closing our eyes, let us say, "Oh dear God, I love you." Daily you should say, in the morning, in the evening, always you should say with join your hands that, "God, I love you." There are many great people in the world who could experience God's love. There are many people. We will study about a young boy who loved God very much. His name was Kuriakose. He was born in Kerala on February 10, 1805. His mother was a pious woman. She taught baby Kuriakose how to love God. She used to pray to God every morning and every night. that we teachers are also telling you that you should pray in the morning and you should pray in the night. As Kyriakos grew up along with his mother, he too learned to love God, because his mother, she was always praying God, she was loving God. Kyriakos was watching her mother, so he was also loving God and prayed to him. He loved God very much. He considered God as his dad. He loved God as he loved his own dad. You are my father, in you I live. He used to say what? You are my father, in you I live, in you I move, and in you I work, and in you. So, children, we should also love God. God is very great. God is present everywhere. God is very powerful. He can do everything. He made everything. This, I told you that whatever the things you are seeing all around you, all are made by God. So we should love God. Now, children, we will do the exercises which you will do in the book itself. Yes, page number 7. First question is, what was the name given to God by the oldest minister? So, what was the name given to God by the oldest minister? What is the answer? Answer is, the name given to God by the oldest minister was love. The name given to God by the oldest minister was love. Second question is, do you believe in God's love towards you, children? Do you believe in God's love towards you? Yes, very good. Yes, I believe in God's love towards me. I believe in God's love towards me. Write any 4 loving gifts God has given you. I told you so many things that God has given us, so many things. So here you are supposed to write 4 gifts that God has given to you. So I have written, teachers, you are agree with me? God has given you this gift? All of you are? Yes. Parents, this gift God has given you, parents and brothers or sisters God has given you, and God has given you friends. So you can write any 4 name, whatever you like, that God has given you. And now, the talent that God gave me. What? I told you that so many talents, na? Sometime one girl is, if she is singing very nicely, so always we say that God gifted. So the God has each one, God has given us so many talents that whatever talents you are, God gave us, I am writing, you also write with me. Yes, children. First is ability to read. God has given us ability to read. So first talent that God gave me is ability to read. Ability to read. Next talent, ability to think. Ability to think. And another talent God gave us is ability to walk. एंड नेक्स्ट इज एबिलिटी टू स्टडी. And next is ability to, yes, what children? Ability to play. All of you love to play? Yes, ability to play. Now next is next talent, ability to sing. Children, you love singing? Yes, ability to sing. Next is ability to dance. I know. All of you love to dance. Yes, ability to dance. And next is ability to smile. I always tell children that you should always smile. Smiling face. Always, all love smiling face. So you should always smile. God has given us beautiful smile. So ability to smile. Next is ability to paint. Now, you love children painting? Ability to ability to paint. And next is next, what talent? Next is ability to love. Most important thing, ability to love. I have written here, children, ability to read, ability to think, ability to walk, ability to study, ability to play, ability to sing, ability to dance, ability to smile, ability to paint, ability to love. You can write so many gifts, so many talents that God has given you. Ability to help, ability to draw, ability to be honest, ability to be ability to be obedient. So many talents that God has given you. So now in the last we will say, I love you, dear God, not this much, not that much, but so much, so much, so much. God, I love you. And we should thank God. We always say that, thank you, God, for the world so sweet. Thank you, God, for the things we see. Thank you, God, for the food we eat. And thank you, God, for everything. Now, yes, all of you have understood, children? Good. Okay, children, stay safe, stay at home, pray every day. Okay, bye-bye. We will meet soon. Bye-bye, children. Thank you. Hello.